Hey guys, welcome back to Naughty Threats. In case you're new here, do subscribe and hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. This design is extremely interesting. I absolutely loved working this design. So watch the video till the end and you will learn yourself. So now let's get started. For today's design, I'm using 6 strands of silk thread and my regular crochet hook number 10. So first we'll work the baseline. For the baseline, I am doing 3 chains and 1 single crochet. So I will be starting by fixing the knot here. So fix the knot and then I will work 3 chains and 1 single crochet. So 3 chains and 1 single crochet. So this will be the baseline and you will have to work until you reach the other end of the pallu. So I have worked about so much distance and I have turned the fabric. Now in case you're working this on a sari, you will have to work this baseline until you reach the end of the pallu and then turn the pallu. So the next step I'm going to continue in the same color. So here in the first block, I will just make one single crochet. I have worked one single crochet in the first block. Then I'll work 3 chains and one double crochet inside the single crochet. Again, 3 chains, 1 double crochet in this gap in between the previous chain and double crochet. So this way we will do 10 stitches. 3 chains and 1 double crochet. When you're working double crochet, the length has to be small. And even the chains have to be really small. So I've done 4. I'll have to do 6 more. So I worked 10 stitches. I'm going to fix this now. So I started working from the first block. I will skip 1, 2 and 3 and then in the fourth block I'm going to work 1 single crochet to fix this. Then I'm going to work 3 chains and skip the next block. I'm not going to do anything in the next block. Skip one and in the next one I will do 1 single crochet. So after I do single crochet, I will just continue the same pattern I did for this, that is 3 chains and 1 double crochet. 3 chains, the first double crochet will go into the single crochet stitch. So same way you will do 10 stitches. I have reached the end here and I'm going to trim this first color because for the second step I'm going to change the color. So I'll leave about 4 to 5 inches long thread and I'll trim this, and the loop that is on the needle I'm going to pull it out. So here I will join my second color, which is pink. So holding both together, I'll make 2 knots. Now we'll turn the work. And we'll work back on these stitches. So So I'll start from this single crochet here, pull a loop and make a chain so that I get a loop on the needle. Now in this loop, I'm going to work one half double. So half double is nothing but when you pass the loop through all three stitches instead of two and two, that is what is a half double crochet. So I worked one half double and then I will work four chains and make one single crochet inside that half double crochet. So again, in the next loop, one half double. Four chains, and in the gap, as in between the previous stitch and the half double, there is a small gap. In that gap you will be working a single crochet. So this will form like a bud here. So since we have 10 stitches, even this step we will be getting 10 stitches. I have finished working two arches here. Now when you reach this part where we have worked three chains, you will simply do two single crochets. So this is my first single crochet and second single crochet, and then you will start your half double crochet directly in the first loop here. So after half double, I'm going to work four chains and make a single crochet in this gap. So same way we'll continue and finish the design. So here there are three empty blocks because we worked this single crochet in the fifth block. So there were three empty blocks, and since it was looking too empty, I added a mini tassel. Let me show you guys the length. It is very small and it really gives a very nice and traditional touch to this design. So this step is completely optional. If you don't want tassel, you can just hang a pom-pom or just a small bead hanging or even a parrot. There are wooden parrots available, wooden elephants available, so you can hang any of those. And in case if you want, you can add some beads here as well, just to give it a little more grand look. But by now I guess you know me guys. I don't like to use too much beads, so I thought of just keeping it simple like this. So I absolutely loved this design and I'm sure I'm going to work this design on one of my saris very soon. So in case you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you have not. And if you happen to try this design, share it on Facebook, join our group, the Crochet Club by Naughty Threads, and you can exchange your crochet related work. So I guess that's all. In case you guys are not aware, I have a blog, naughtythreads.net. So do check it out. I'm trying to update it every day. And if you have not subscribed to my vlog channel, do subscribe to Kanika Reddy Vlogs. I guess that's it. Yeah, before I forget, I have worked this design using silk thread. In case you're doing an edging on your cotton sari, you can use cotton thread, or even kamal kadai thread will give it a very good outcome. So do give it a try. I guess, yeah, that's all. So I shall see you guys soon with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care guys. Bye-bye.